Hello my dear students and friends, welcome to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 17. In today's session we will see about an assembly of bolt and nut. Let us see about how to make M6 bolt and M6 nut, right? For that, the previous day file was exercise 21 up to exercise 21. We finished it, you know. So here, exercise 22. There are three files. One is a bolt, other one is a nut, and third one is the assembly of bolt and nut. Okay. So that is the idea. So this is the M6. M6 bolt and nut will be making it. Okay, we are not making it exactly. We'll make using the key parameters, not all the parameters. Okay, if I include all the parameters, it will take more time for me to complete, and the session will be a lengthier session. Okay, the important parameters we'll take. Let us see what is important parameter. We'll go to images. Okay, we are doing it live. M6 Allen bolt. This is about M6 Allen bolt. Now you see, you have the images. So this is how the M6 Allen bolt will look. The length will vary. So this length, this is 15 mm length. The threaded part, the from the head till this tip, it is 15 mm. This length can be anything, 15, 20. In step of 5 only, generally in step of 5 only, you will get you will get the nut or the bolt, Allen bolts, right? This is you can use the Allen key. The other one is a hexagonal head. You have if you have hexagonal head, you should use spanner. Right, M6, M10, metric thread spanners are there. Okay, that you have to use. Here you have to use the Allen key. Okay, in industries, this kind of bolt is used largely. The hexagonal type of bolts are used in some household items, plumbing and other things. Right, but when it comes to industrial machineries, mostly they use this kind of Allen bolt only. That is why I have taken this as the example. Now we take let us see about this one. Yes, okay. Now I opened the page. I think it directly goes to AliExpress page. Now since the order of the day is COVID, you know, so mostly we see the COVID related the mask, the face shields, all the other things only are on display now in AliExpress, especially because that is out of the day. Okay, so this is how it looks. Now here we see M6, the pitch is 1 mm. We'll see that later. The DK, first let us take the DK. No, so this DK 10.2 maximum, 9.78. I'll take it 10. Okay, then what is the height? The height is K. The K is 6 mm. The K is 6 mm. So first we'll make these, take the new file, right? So let me draw in top view the circle whose diameter is 10. There is a head we are making. Its height is 6. Okay, that way. Okay, 6. See, actually what I am telling you, see here, they will be having some fillet or chamfer and some knurlings and all will be there. I am not doing all these things. I take the key essential points for making the nut and the bolt, and I'll show you the assembly of it, right? So let me save it as exercise 22-1. Okay, so this is the bolt. 22-2 is the nut. EX22 alone is the assembly. Okay, those three files will be available in the link. Okay, now there is a hexagonal hole here. In the hole only, you have to, using the Allen key, you have to fasten the bolt. Right. So we'll see that the hexagon, the opposite edges, the gap is S. For M6, the S is maximum 5.14 and 5.02. I'll take 5.1. Okay, I'll take 5.1. Okay, what is the depth? The depth is T. Yeah, for M6, the T is 3 mm. After that, there is a dent also. I am not considering the dent, okay, or a fillet. I am not considering that. We'll draw only that hexagon. S is for M6. S is 5.1. The depth is 3. Okay. So here, I'll be drawing a hexagon. Let me make it horizontal. Okay, so this is 5.1, right? Yes, the depth is the cut, extruded cut, depth is 3. So this portion is over. Now this side, the D, nominal diameter D for M6, the pitch is 1, D is not given here, D is not given here. Let us see whether it has been given in somewhere. Okay, the D is 6. This D is 6. Okay. Now I am drawing a sketch. That is M6, you know. M6 means that the diameter is 6. Actually, it will be 5.9 or 5.95. 0.05 or 0.1 mm less, actually. Right? Okay. So as I said earlier, we will creating some key points only. So the length, I want this to be, say, okay, so 30 mm, sorry, 30. So this is how it looks. Okay, again I repeat, I didn't introduce any fillet or chamfer in those corners, edges, and I didn't put any knurling and all. Okay, again there will be some fillet or chamfer here, then there will be a fillet in the bottom side. So all these things I will be skipping, and here also there is a fillet. So I will be skipping all these things. I will be skipping all those. Okay, now we will go for the thread. For the thread, you need the helix first. So let me, for the helix you need a circle. I am selecting this one, this plane now. Then I am selecting this edge, convert entity. So an edge is made here, on edge it is made. Circle, I got it. Okay, why I am going for convert entities means, even thereafter I will be saving this as I may be saving this file as M8 nut, M8 bolt. So that time it will be, if I change the dimension of this one from 6 to 8, this will also be changed to 8 automatically. So that is the beauty of this convert entities, actually. Okay, so these are something like relational constraints. Okay, so that is over. Then sketch selected, insert, curve, helix. Yes, pitch and revolution. Pitch is 1 mm. Then revolution, I don't want the full length, right? It is full length is, if I am correct, okay, let me check the full 30 I put, yes, 30. That means a 30 revolution I have to put, but let me put only 20 revolution, 20 revolutions only, right? So a plain shank you will have for 10 mm. So pitch is 1 mm. Number of revolution, the whole, this whole length is 30, but I want the thread up to 20. Oh, sorry, it has gone on the other side. So reverse direction. Again, it should be clockwise, right? Yeah, it is clockwise. It is clockwise. You see, clockwise. If it is counterclockwise, you just see that it goes this way. No, counterclockwise, it goes this way. Now you see that. Okay, now clockwise. So if I, from this view, if I tilt in the clockwise direction, the nut has to move forward. So that is the logic. So a helix is made. Then at the tip of the helix, I have to draw a triangular cut actually. Again, I am telling you, I am using only the key points actually. So something is still missing. It is not 100% perfect, but these are essentials. Those are not so essential actually, that can be completed also, okay, after some time. Let me save, then go for new, because a path is made. So I want to use a cut sweep. For the cut sweep, through using the cut sweep only, I can make the thread, V thread. So the cut, for the cut sweep, the sweep, there are two sketches required. One is the path and the other one is the profile. Now this is the path. Path is the open profile. This helix is the path. The profile is a V cut. Yeah, triangle I have to make, right? For that, I should have another sketch. Okay, so that is over. Now at this particular point, I want to make one triangle now. Okay, so yeah, plane is made. Let me hide the plane's visibility. I have selected the plane, so I have gone for thread now. So before making the thing, let me put a point somewhere here and let me make it 0, 0. Press OK, escape. Then again, it is 0, 0. I'm fixing it. Then, with respect to that, I am about to draw a triangle for making the V-cut. Now I'm about to make a V cut. This one, a small protrusion I'll be making. So let this be just 0.5 mm. 0.2 maybe. Oh, it goes this much. Okay, 0.1 let it be. Okay. Then the pitch is 1 mm. That means it is better if it is 0.9. Let these things, two things, to be equal. Then for the net, the inner dia is 5 mm. So that means this should be 0.5. This should be 0.5. It is better if it is 0.8. Let us see. We can change it up always, actually. In the meantime, we'll check what is the angle between these two. the angle between these two 77, it should not be 77. Okay, we'll see. Okay, we'll see. Again, I said we are not doing it, but it is at least 80% exact. Okay, not 100% perfect, but 80% is exact. Okay, all the key ingredients we use, so that is okay. So we have to make a note of these parameters, because the same parameters only to be incorporated in the net also, right? In the nut also. So let me choose by using the control key. I chose both the sketches. Now I am going for sweep cut. That's it. Oh, sorry, it is in the other way. Let me erase all. Small extension. The extension is just 0.1. Then this length is 0.5. Then I'll be drawing a triangle this way. This is at the midpoint. And these two are equal. Then this length is 0.5. This cannot be, because already this is 0.1, 0.5. So it is not a driving member, it will be a driven member only. This height I have to set. Okay, let it be 0.7, we'll see, or maybe 0.8, because the pitch is 1 mm. Okay, so now let me choose both the thing, then I go for the sweep cut. Now you see that a cut is made now. Cut is made. Okay. Now, slightly I'll do some more slight editing. Instead of 0.8, let me put 0.9. Let me escape. Okay, let it be 0.1 mm. What is the helical parameter? Pitch is 1 mm, 20. Okay. Still I have some land here, right? I should not. Okay, I'll make it 0.6. Let us see what happens. This should be 0.5. This I'll make it 0.05. Yeah. Okay. So small flatness you'll get, of course. Okay. So a thread is made here. So that is a thing. Right. Now, what I'll do is let me put a different color here. Then I'll be saving this as save as nut. Okay, so this is nut actually now. Okay, I'll put it in the reverse way. Let me do some helix is drawn, right? Let it be visible. The helix for the net, again let me see the M6 nut images. So we'll take these simple parameters. Okay, you see for M6 only three parameters I'll be taking: the S, the M, the chamfer and all. I'm also see, you see that there is a fillet here. Fillets are there. Okay, I'm not considering those fillets. I am considering only this S and M. Of course, the D is the pitch diameter. The for the nut is should have a hole. The hole dia for the nut is for the M6 is 5 mm. For the M6 nut, the hole dia is 5 mm. Okay. So that is not that hole dia is 5 mm. This thickness is also 5 mm. The thickness is also 5 mm. This S value is 10 mm. Okay, so that is a point. Now in between the 5 mm, you know, that means I want this to be 5 turns, or let it be 6 otherwise. After that we can cut some more. In the meantime, what I'll be doing is let me choose this face where I am. Now I want to convert the nut in, bolt into nut. Okay, instead of creating a nut separately, so what is this one? The S for M6, 10 mm. So this one to be horizontal, and this distance between these two is 10 mm. That's it. Then this face convert into this. Then what is the thickness? The thickness M is 6 mm, right? 5 mm, sorry. So I want to boss extrude other direction 5 mm. Then what I'll be doing here is, let me get this convert entity of this circle onto this particular surface. I am drawing a sketch up here. Okay, so I got the projection of this circle onto this particular sketch plane. Using that, I want to cut the full portion, the above portion, this portion. Okay, what I am doing is, I am not making a nut separately from the part, the bolt I developed, you know. So from that only I am doing, I am making the nut. So that is why I am doing somewhat a lengthy procedure. This is 6, sorry, this must be 5, this must be 5, cut through. Now let me see the cut sweep. I have to do some editing here. Let us see what happens. It has made a inner cut actually. Let me put 0.7 this case, see what happens. Point 0.9, let me put what happens, you see. Actually it should be the other way. Triangle should be inverted, right? What I can do is I'll do simply a simple thing. I'll do let me 0.8 through this midpoint. Through this midpoint, I want to mirror this one, these three, okay? About this, I want to mirror. Then let me convert this as under construction type, okay? I think it may be confusing for you, okay? But slowly you play the video, so then you will get some idea about. So now your thread is made now. Okay, again small step here, step is there here. Kindly ignore those things, because again I told you already, our intention is to show you the bolt and nut assembly. Now let me, if I cut, you'll see the thread. You see the thread portion, right? So instead of making a nut separately from the bolt, I made the nut. So to save some steps, especially for this particular video session. But in actual, I won't do like this, okay? I'll be creating a nut afresh, freshly, right? So because to save some time only, I am, see, again, I'm telling you, here there are some fillets, fillet in these edges, chamfer here, there, and some refinement will be there. You will not have this much land actually. So there are certain issues, but we will be avoiding all those things. To cut short the time, I avoided this one. So now let me open both what is the file name, 22. Is not here. Think probably it would have gone face shield. Okay, let me close this. It is stored in some other thing. Okay, in 2020 face shield it has been saved. So yes, let me cut and paste it here. So I am opening both 21-1, 21-2, both the files I opened. Now if you see tile horizontally, this is the nut bolt file and this is the nut file, okay? So that is one point. The part is over, we have to go for assembly. But before going for assembly, now if I rotate the nut, all the six faces are equal. You will not see that as if I am rotating the nut, right? For that purpose alone, I am drawing one, adding one more small feature. Okay, it is only for visibility purpose, visualization purpose. As if I rotate the nut, you should have an illusion that I am rotating the nut. That is why I am introducing a small feature maybe a 20 mm pin like structure I'm adding. Then only, so if I tilt, you see, you can see the rotation by observing this particular knob, this particular extension. Okay, otherwise it is not necessary. Okay, now let us go for the assembly. Okay, again I repeat, bolt is one file, 22 minus 1. This is 22 minus 2 nut. I introduce this feature, a small protrusion, a cylindrical type of protrusion. Why I did so is, then only if I rotate the nut to lock and unlock the nut in the bolt, you know, you should see and you should have a feel that I am rotating the nut. For that purpose only I introduce this one, right? With the position of this one, you can see, you can understand how I made the how I am tightening and loosening the nut. That is the logic. Okay, now we go for assembly. New assembly, escape, plain white. Now inside the item, I want lock the pin it, the bolt to be fixed, nut is moving. So bolt I want to fix it, I want to insert first, because in the assembly, while inserting the component you are inserting first, that becomes a fixed member. Okay, that is the point. So I inserted both. Okay, now we go for mating. Let us make the cylindrical mate first. So this is cylinder. Okay, let me put only, I added only one parallel thing. So this is moving. This is moving. Here now I added only one relation, that is both are concentric. So if this will not move, it can move, it can slide over this one. If I add one more thing, I think that is sufficient to make the constraint as a bolt and nut. See carefully. I am choosing this point, actually this point onto the net. This is very 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 important. And this has to, let me see once again. So this point on this face, right? So mating, I am choosing, this is very important again, this point on the net and this surface on the net. That's it. Now if you see, I introduce only two mating conditions. So select either the nut part or the bolt part, and property manager, if you go, I used only two constraints, two mating constraints, concentric and coincident. In the coincident, a point on the net, a point on the thread portion of the net and the helical portion, helical face of the bolt. Okay, now you see the, this is the front view, this is the side view, and this is the top view. This is the top view, or this is the bottom view. Okay, from the bottom only we suppose to insert the net, right? Now again, now as if you see the gap, the position of the net with respect to the bolt. Now you see that. Okay, now go to the bottom view. Now I will be tilting this one. 1, 2, 3. Now you see the front view. Okay, otherwise in the isometric we'll see that. 1. Now I am tight. Okay, it is not behaving properly. Yeah, now you see the motion. Now let it be closer. Or otherwise, what we can do is, I think we'll I think it is working actually, but instead of selecting the plane as the coincident, let me choose this point. This helical portion, or it will be difficult. Okay, we'll choose both. Only this is the possibility. This is the possibility. It's supposed to work actually. You saw now you see the there is you see the position of the net with respect to the bolt. Now I'm slightly moving. What happened? Let me do one thing. Let me choose this point and this one. Okay. Then I am slowly rotating this one. Okay, see, it has some minor hitch only. Let me open another assembly file that I have created some time back. Okay, so from that we'll see how I made this one. Okay, I am opening another set of the files that I've created. Where is it? Screw and nut. This is the assembly. So this is the thing. Now you see the position of this particular one. Okay, the position, the position of the net with respect to the thread actually, right? Let me see the bottom view. Now I am rotating 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now you see it has moved up. Okay, let me do it three times more. It will go to that extreme. 1, 2, 3. Again, I'm telling you, this particular protrusion, I made it so then you can have a visualization that as if I'm tilting the net. Now you see, it is fully tightened. It is fully tightened. Let me loosen it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that is 10 times I rotated. You see the front view? Now you see it has moved down. So this is how you can make this one. Anyway, you will get these files, okay, in the link. There is a minor hitch, so I'll correct it. After making the correction, I will be uploading that onto the setup. So then you can view it as you wish, right? As per perfectly. Okay. Now it is not rotating perfectly smoothly. That is the only problem. But it's supposed to work actually. Okay. So that is for today. So we saw. A bolt and nut, in that more specifically a metric M6 thread type of nut. So for that we got some inputs from these from the internet. What is the pitch circle, what is the pitch, what is the diameter of the head, the hexagonal hole, and for the nut. So all those things we have obtained from the internet only. So with that we made this file, right? Or else, I'll give you this also. Where is this file? This I'll give this also. Okay, if you see that now, I use only these two concentric. Yeah, for concentric I used I didn't use the face. For concentric I used this one. Maybe that may be the case. That may be the case. Okay, so I'll make the correction and I'll do it. But okay, so as if it will work. So that's it for the today. So kindly subscribe my channel and inform this to our other students and friends, so then they'll also get some inputs on SolidWorks from my side. Thank you.